Yes, Tasnim and Zamel on this Monday afternoon, 20th of October 2014. Uh-huh. And we're talking about property as well as budget, right?
Okay.
How do these two actually mesh up, and also how is it going to be like in the property landscape in 2015?
Okay, and and most importantly, youngsters, you know, you've been hearing them complaining and keep complaining and whining on how expensive houses are and how can they afford houses these days.
Exactly.
So, speaking on which, on the recently, the budget also tabled a few incentives and a lot of brilliant measures being going to be taken in order to resolve this problem so that youngsters like us
are able to afford to buy properties.
Yeah,
okay. And become property developer like
Tan Sri. Our guest.
Right, so we'd like to welcome our guest in the studio, Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Dato' Sri Dr. MP Ramasamy, who is a businessman, who is a property developer. He's also involved, you know, also in politics, right?
Yes.
So especially, he is the IRDK Land Group Managing Director. Apa khabar? How are you, Tan Sri?
Tan Sri? Yes. You look very young for someone as young as you are. Has achieved a lot.
A lot of things.
Thank
very
you for coming.
Colorful.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay.
For inviting me.
No problem.
Well,
it's our pleasure for us to have you here and to share all your knowledge and your experience in the property sector.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's begin with, before we go in detail, so let's begin with the
budget
2015. Okay. What's your overall
opinion?
Your view on the budget being tabled?
Okay. To me, the budget is a healthy budget. The reason, the budget overall, 273.9 billion, increase about 9.8 billion compared to earlier budget.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, I feel the government look healthy, and the government progress of the government also healthy.
Mm.
And furthermore, they reduce 1% for individual tax.
That's right.
And company tax.
That's right.
And SME, small business holders tax as well.
Mm-hmm. Very good incentive already.
Yeah, yeah, very good. Really. Therefore, I feel it's a good budget. Yeah. Mm.
Wonderful. Focusing also on the property sector from you, from your side as a property developer, what about the incentive in terms of the 50% stamp duty exemption for, you know, the loan agreements that's been increased for the purchase limit for people to become, you know, first time home buyers, right? So it's been increased from 400,000
to 500,000 now.
Yeah. Yeah. So do you think this is a good move, a good incentive?
I feel this is a good move. The reason, this is good for the couples and the youngsters.
Like
this is a
like
good
us.
Approach. Like you all, I don't think so. You all have a house, own house.
Not yet.
Yes. Yes.
So all this a good opportunity implemented by our Prime Minister. Is you all should be happy on this. So I feel this is a good concept and a good approach by the government.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay, Tan Sri, just to check with you, is 2015 a good time to own a property with all that has been introduced, the incentives, the good news that have been announced?
Very good question, actually. Mm. To me, in Malaysia, every year is a good year to buy property.
Really?
Yeah. The reason, compared to other countries, our property is still cheaper. But because of GST, the impact will be there for next year. For this year, no GST. GST for the properties, for residential, no GST.
Okay.
But commercial also no GST.
Right.
But but construction cost will be increased 6% GST.
Raw materials.
Raw material, all that. So that 6%, it will impact on the property price.
Right.
Therefore, even we can minimize that, the government should take into consideration to check on the raw material of construction material.
Oh.
Right. Mm. Like a construction material in our country, let's say.
Yep.
We have our own sand, one aggregate, one quarry, one cement, all that, extra, extra, extra. But government should go into one these issues to control the raw material, to reduce the price on the raw material, then we can go back to the normal price as we have now.
That's
very, very important. So the government, you see, to me, a GST is very important for the country.
Mm.
You know, like a developed country. You look at a developed country. All the country has the GST.
Yeah, they already implemented GST.
That's
So our country, developing country, GST should implement. Otherwise, we won't develop.
True.
We won't develop mind set of public.
Yeah.
This is good for the country, healthy.
Mm.
Another thing, like a government, there are business people also.
Yes.
I'm a businessman, government also business.
That's yes. right.
Without revenue, no business.
Mm.
Right. So, this is all this, the collection of the GST is goes back to the public.
Mm.
They're not going to keep. They're going to give back to the public. Therefore, to me, GST should have, like a property sector, to me, the government should control the material cost of the construction
cost. Raw material
right.
Then should not be a problem.
Coming from one of the leading property developers in Malaysia, IRDK Land Group, tell us about your developments that you have been doing for the past few years, or even since IRDK Land has been established.
Yeah.
Your current development?
Yeah. So far, my development only in Klang Valley.
That's good.
But I haven't tried other area. The reason, I'm happy what I'm doing here.
Of course.
And furthermore, as a country, the city is important to develop.
Yeah.
To me, in Kuala Lumpur, Klang Valley, there's a pocket lands is still available, a lot of lands. So we should develop. Therefore, my development, current development in Shalom.
Mm.
I created one township.
Mm.
You know, Shalom section 60.
Yep.
All right. I created one township, and even I'm putting up this convention center, banquet hall, and cinemas, all that for public.
Yep.
Because not everything money, business.
What's on screen now is the one in Puchong as well.
Right here, that we're showing now.
Yeah.
Country?
This is Puchong.
Yeah.
Puchong, I just launched. This is actually commercial location.
Mm.
But residential status we are giving.
Oh.
Right.
So always I look at the lifestyle of people. We should improve mindset of people.
Mm-hmm.
We have to improve our lifestyle
in
Malaysia. The reason we are a developing country. So Shalom, Puchong, and future in Ampang. Mm. So I'm developing as a mixed development. Depend on the demand.
Mm-hmm.
Important demand. So. And facilities, we should give a facilities. Nowadays, youngsters look at the security and IT and the landscape,
infrastructure,
and the facilities, all that. All that very important. Always we emphasize on the quality and delivery, all that. That's very important. Normally, we work with the zero defect concept.
At zero least, defect concept?
Yeah.
Okay, explain on that.
Okay. Zero defect concept. From beginning, when I implement the project, I will emphasize, make sure no defect.
Hmm.
When we deliver the key,
everything is in tip-top condition.
At least they will achieve 95%. That's good enough.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, I emphasize all the project with zero defect.
So with this coming budget 2015, in the coming years, basically, how is IRDK Land Group is accommodating to give more development for first-time home buyers like us?
Yeah.
How are you making it more affordable?
Yeah, see, let's say in Ampang, I have one medium class of apartments.
Mm.
Another apartment that's low cost.
Mm. Right.
But I'm talking to the Selangor government, low cost is out of fashion.
Yes.
The reason our lifestyle
has changed
above the low cost.
Exactly.
So I am requesting them, I want to go for Prima Housing or Selangor. So this lifestyle will change. Otherwise, I go for low cost, it will become slum again.
Yes.
People buy, they give it to the foreigners.
Mm.
So it will become slum. Then how to develop the country? Therefore, to me, low cost should not implement anymore. We should go for like a Prima Housing and a Selangor. That's
a good concept.
A good concept and good ideas.
This is also to keep up with the increasing cost of living.
Yeah.
You know, we are moving forward.
Lifestyle.
Yeah, lifestyle.
Because now youngsters' lifestyle are different.
Yes.
Not the low cost. We cannot push them to low cost again.
Yes.
That's right.
And the mentality will be different.
Yeah.
So I'm talking to the government actually. Mm.
So what are the responses so far?
Okay, like, there's a positive response. They accepted my proposal.
Uh-huh.
So I'm waiting for their reply.
Mm. So we can register soon.
Oh, of course. Yeah.
Good news, Amil.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's what we've been waiting to say. We want to register.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
What about the Prima, like you said?
Yeah.
How is the concept of Prima, in your opinion? Is it a really good concept to encourage
Our Prime Minister
Yeah.
proposed the Prima Housing. He announced 80,000 units he should deliver before next general election.
That's right.
Yes.
But I see the progress of the Prima Housing is still slow.
Mm.
So this government should expedite on this project.
Yeah.
Okay.
To complete what our Prime Minister says. All this, they should help Prime Minister should deliver all this before next general election.
Mm.
And this is a benefit to the public and the youngsters.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tan Sri, another interesting introduction in the budget for the property sector is the rent-to-own scheme, which is said to help those to obtain financing easily.
Mm.
So what is your opinion on that?
Mm. Come again?
The rent-to-own scheme.
That means you pay...
You pay...
Sort of like a rent. Mm. Uh-huh. But in the end, it's you paying it just to own. Lah.
Yes.
It's like leasing.
Leasing, yes. Yeah. What do you...
Leasing concept.
What's your
to
take
me,
on that?
I haven't studied about it.
Yeah.
Because this is a bit complicating.
Yeah.
Okay.
Issues. So to me, we buy, we sell. Mm-hmm. Easier.
Easier. Yeah.
And we transfer the property direct to them.
Uh-huh.
Let's say this leasing is long term.
That's right. Mm.
Anything can happen to me or to the purchaser.
Yeah.
So it, all this confusing.
Yeah.
To me, it's not right.
But as a property developer, do you think there's enough supply of housing, residential for
me,
people in Malaysia?
To me, depend on the location.
Number of demand.
Okay.
No. To me, depend on the location.
Okay.
Depend on your product. Depend on your concept.
Right.
Depend on your design.
Mm.
All that. And depend on your price.
Yes.
And the money trap. That's very important.
Mm.
Therefore, in Klang Valley, demand is still there. So, it's up to the developers what they're giving and should give the competitive price and the facilities.
Mm-hmm.
Now, youngsters looking at the, you know,
all
the
that.
Facilities.
Yes,
that's right.
And
facilities,
IT, all that.
Safety.
And
security.
Safety, like
important.
A garden.
Yes.
Garden. Mm-hmm. All this is very important.
Accessibility.
Yeah, not like those days.
Yeah.
When we brought up.
Yeah.
Now the youngsters are different.
Yes.
So we have to compare with the world. Global. We should speak about global development.
Okay.
And not only our country. Normally I compare about other country and our country. How we are developed. How to improve. Always I go to overseas, look at a building only.
Mm.
Yeah. Yes. That's true. That's a good point.
Yeah. I will see how about their architecture and how their facade of the building.
Yes.
How's their design?
A lot of
what's the facility like IT, you know, facilities, all that.
Okay, yeah. Tan Sri, let's say they are interested to buy property soon, anytime soon. What should they look into before they actually own a property? These are the things that we miss sometimes. We don't know.
Yeah. This is very, very important question.
Yes.
What
my advice to you or to everyone.
Okay.
Important. Before they commit the property, they should study. They should study about the product, what they're giving, like the square feet sizes,
yes.
Okay.
What the finishes, and what's the security system they're giving.
That's
because
right.
Safety are very important.
That's okay. Right.
And they should think the facilities floors, swimming pool, how big, squash they have or not, surau they have or not,
yes.
Okay.
Badminton they have or not, and playground is there or not, and community hall is there or not. All that they must study the overall.
Okay.
And check with the price and check with the location. All that before commit. And before commit, they should read the S&P.
Ah.
Sales and purchase agreement, they should read.
Mm.
Some people blindly sign.
Yep.
End of the day, they regret why I bought this property so high.
Yeah.
Another thing, as an investor or own the property, they should study. After completion, let's say you stay, whether the property can appreciate or not.
Okay.
That's right.
With your investment.
Yes.
If an investor, let's say they don't stay, whether return of rental can cover their loan or not.
That's right.
Yes.
All that must study. This is my advice to everyone.
Nice. Good advice.
Yeah. Good advice, yeah.
Take points taken.
Yeah. So, aside from the properties that we've shown on TV, the properties in Shah Alam, Puchong and Ampang, any new developments coming up soon?
There's a lot coming up for next year, yeah.
Next year, yeah.
Yeah.
Keep
so
in touch with me.
Is log on to their website, irdklandgroup.com. One word. It's very, very important for you to know all about this, right? And also, of course, can you also highlight a little bit on your CSR activities?
Oh, this is very good.
Yeah.
This to me, I'm a businessman.
Yeah.
And a public serviceman also.
Yeah.
I don't want to say I'm in politics. Okay. So, to me, not everything money.
Yeah.
What I do Image very important, like my product. I implement something, end of the day, people should speak about my product. If they speak about my project, instead of they speak about Ramasamy, right?
Yes.
Therefore, always money is a secondary for me. This image are very, very important. I'll create the image and branding any project I start, one. Same time, CSR. CSR always, from the profit, I'll give it to the public. How will I give? My hometown from Slim River, right? I start from zero.
Right.
Very poor family. My mother was a rubber tap, right? I was 5 years old, my mom passed away. Still, Malaysia is a good country to come up. You hard work, you can come up.
Yeah.
You can learn fast. Lot of opportunity. You know, even a poor can become a rich.
Yeah. Yes.
This is the best country compared to other country. Mm. But what I did, I involved in the politics in MIC since past 20 years in my own place. So that's I use as a base. Yeah. I service the people. Even today, after 3 o'clock, I need to give a lot of amperes, all that.
That's right.
Because of Deepavali.
Yeah.
So that's satisfaction I have. I'm giving something out to the public.
Yeah.
Giving back to the society.
Yeah. It's not just about making money all the way. No. It's also about giving back to the society.
And we should balance our life.
True.
Mm. Everything, even in public, even your business, even your family, that we should balance. If you you balance, you will have a proper satisfaction.
And you have a happy life and look as young as you are.
thank you.
Never ask the age, but
look. He looks young.
Yeah, now we know the secret.
One thing also.
Okay, thank you so much, Tan Sri, for your precious time.
Thank you.
And those things that you've shared with us.
Yeah.
And we definitely look up to you for everything that you've gone through to reach where you are now.
We wish you all the best, Tan Sri. And for more information, if you're a first-time home buyer or if you're looking to buy properties, log on to their website, which is irdklandgroup.com. Okay, we will be posting that website as well on our Facebook page. All you have to do is just log on to the to our Facebook page, facebook.com/hellonto.
Okay, so we hope you filled you in. Today is very informative, I would
say.
Very,
very. A lot of websites to know.
From the start till the end. So thank you so much for being with us. Have a great day. Have a good afternoon and back to work, people.
That's right. Zamel and Tazim signing off for today. Take care, everyone. See you tomorrow. Next.